Luke chapter 1 verse 45. And blessed is she that believed. The caption for this morning meditation: blessed is one that believed, that believes. There shall be a performance of those things which were told her from the Lord. If you believe, you are a blessed person. All those things that have been told you of the Lord, He will perform it. Shall we lift up our hands and say hallelujah, hallelujah? Blessed is the person who believes. All those things the Lord has told that person who believes, He will perform it. It's a very powerful promise. One of the Bible characters I love the most, but even I can say, as far as I am concerned, the most lovable human Bible character, for me, it's Mary. I have preached a number of sermons on Mary. Some time back, I remember we had a powerful sermon, Hail Mary. Hail Mary. And I have preached that sermon in many different places. My dear brother, my dear sister, every Bible character is unique. And I love many Bible characters. I love Peter very much. I see the resemblance of Peter in me. More than Peter, I can say Simon. A type of a boldness, a quick-witted person who wears his heart on his sleeves, not very contemplative like John. Like this, for me, in the Bible, especially in the New Testament, the most admirable, adorable character is Mary. My dear brother, my dear sister, worshipping Mary is not biblical. That started only in the 4th century. In Arabia, by a woman, she started giving the Holy Sacrament to Mary. After 6th century, when they were incorporating the Babylonian mystery, that religion, into Christianity, slowly the Semiramis worship, the worship of Astarte, was changed to worship of Mary. In many places, especially in the Catholic Church, the statue what you see, that is not the statue of Mary, that's the statue of Astarte with Tammuz in her hands. Mary was probably around 13 to 16 years old when Jesus was born. But the woman in that statue was always a middle-aged woman. Generally, women in Palestine, they are short. In Babylon, they are tall. And even before the birth of Jesus Christ, we have got descriptions of Semiramis, very tall, with a sharp nose. and her hair was golden. But Mary, a Jewish woman, her hair must be black. More than that, that statue, she is generally known with her blue eyes. That's a description of Semiramis. Even the literature of Homer, a few hundred years before Jesus was born. Only for your information. That statue, what we see with the child in the hands. Semiramis gave birth to Tammuz when she was in the middle age after the death of Nimrod. My dear brother, my dear sister, in the Bible, the record of Mary, mother of Jesus, is very few. Biblically speaking, not very significant. Two of the evangelists, Mark and John, totally omit the birth of Jesus Christ. Two of the evangelists, Mark and John, in their Gospels, they totally omit the birth of Jesus Christ. The other evangelist, Matthew, though he gives a mention of the birth of Jesus Christ through a virgin to the fulfillment of prophecy of Isaiah, Matthew also doesn't write a single word about the nativity. In chapter 2, it is switched over to the house of Nazareth. At that time, Jesus must have been around 2 years old. Biblically, wise men never came to the manger. The star never led the wise men to the manger. So out of 4 Gospels, 3 of the evangelists don't even mention about the nativity. It's only Luke gives a recording about the nativity. But if you read carefully, all the 4 Gospels talk about the sufferings of Jesus Christ, the Lord's Supper, Gethsemane, Jesus' death, burial, resurrection, ascension into heaven. This part of Jesus' life has been discussed in all the 4 Gospels, but not the birth of Christ. Today the church has become ultra. They give a type of an undue importance to the birth of Christ. You don't read in the Bible, neither Mary, nor his co-bonds, nor his disciples, nor the early church ever celebrated the birthday of Jesus Christ at any day. If you read I don't know why I say this, you can share with others with love and affection. If you read the epistles, there's only one place Paul was mentioning Mary, if at all we can search for it. About Jesus, he says, Jesus born of women. So he was not mentioning the name Mary even when he was writing to the epistles. He said, Jesus born of women. There is no other mention of Mary. In the book of Revelation, not once Mary was mentioned. But I love the character of Mary. There are a lot of things that we have to study from the life of Mary. apart from the nativity. In the gospel records, Mary comes only thrice. In all those three times, Mary plays a very low key. In the wedding of Cana, and once coming to meet Jesus with her other children. It's a wrong belief that Mary didn't have any other children. Through Joseph she had children. Through Joseph Mary had children. And once when they are going to the temple, there also we see Mary as a very simple woman, not very prudent, left her son, walked for 3 days without knowing whether the son is with her or not. She thought maybe with the relatives. We don't see her as a very prudent woman there. Even in the wedding of Cana, it seemed that she didn't understand Jesus.
When she was coming to take back Jesus home with other children, there also we see Mary didn't understand the ministry of Jesus fully.
Apart from this, at the cross, at the tomb, we see Mary, mother of Jesus, with others. So as I told you earlier, we don't see a very prominent role of Mary in any of these situations. Again, in the Acts of the Apostles, on the day of the Pentecost, we think Mary was with the other disciples. She also received the Holy Spirit with the anointing, as we believe. But we don't see that she had any leadership role or anybody worshipped her or any special mention of Mary in that place. You'll surprise. I think it was 1854, in the 900 and odd years back. By the then Pope, the Immaculate Concept of Mary came. It's a very erroneous teaching. To give birth to Jesus, Mary must be without original sin. To give birth to Jesus, Mary must be without original sin. To give birth to Mary without original sin, her mother must be without original sin. Then her grandmother must be without original sin. It's very irrational. I forgot the name of the Pope. In 1854 only, the 19th century, for the first time, the Immaculate Concept of Mary came. It's not earlier. Okay. Why do I say all these things? Absolutely. Mary worship, praying through Mary, thinking God is very cruel, Jesus is very helpless, Mary is very passionate, with more understanding. God the Father wanted to bruise his own son. This son cried on the cross, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? No use in going to this God who bruised his own son. And the son who cried, my father, why hast thou forsaken me? It's better we go to Mary. Because the worship of woman God, the Shakti, Astarte, Devi, it has been a practice all over the world. That is the root of all religions, all false religions. But I encourage the church, study the characteristics of that simple woman. A woman, a vessel chosen by God to to give birth to Jesus Christ. Of course, it is grace. She found favor in the sight of God. If that favor is given to somebody in India, that woman would have given birth to Jesus. Or if that favor is given to somebody in Africa, that woman would have given birth to Jesus. She found favor in the sight of God. But here we see one more description which I never meditated on made. Mary probably 13 years old at that time, 13 to 16 years old. She found favor in the sight of God. She submitted to the will of God very humbly, in a simpleton way. She believed God. She believed God. Here, I don't know how many of you have noticed. I want to speak very elaborately on it, but the time will not permit. I was able to see these two women, Elizabeth and Mary. Elizabeth was a matured woman. She's from the tribe of a priestly tribe. Her husband was a priest. But when Mary came, this Elizabeth excited. She was filled with the Holy Spirit. And she spoke with a loud voice about the Blessed Mary. She was excited, filled with the Holy Spirit, spoke with a loud voice. Many people take this as the hymn of Mary. In English, it is generally called Magnificat. Magnificat. I don't know what they call this passage in Tamil. But biblically, it is not a hymn. It is not a song. She just spoke. We don't read she filled with the Holy Spirit. We don't read she spoke in an ecstasy. She spoke in a loud voice, very gently, in a composed way. She spoke her heart out. What is the reason for her statements? There, Elizabeth says, "He that believes is a blessed person. You believe. And what is told you of the Lord, He will perform it. He will perform it." At that time, I assume, Elizabeth didn't know what God has told Mary. She didn't know fully what God has told Mary. But then, in the anointing, Elizabeth says, "What is told you by the Lord, or of the Lord, He shall perform it. He that believes is a blessed person." Then in a very candid way, Mary is telling Elizabeth what the Lord has said. I don't know how did Luke find that out. I don't know. Probably very carefully, Luke must have inquired this to Mary about this Annunciation, John the Baptist. This reference is found in Quran. One full chapter is devoted for Mary in Quran. One full chapter. More importance to Mary is given in Quran than in the Bible. So probably she would explain to Luke. So I went to Elizabeth's case. Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost and she gave a prophecy like this. Then I said this like this. In a latter day, Mary might have told this to Luke, because he inquired everything in detail and he wrote the gospel according to Luke. The nativity and other things. Most probably Mary would explain that to Luke personally. My dear brother, my dear sister, just we read that passage. And I was able to see a beautiful faith in her. A beautiful faith of Mary in God. We read from verse 46.
And Mary said, My soul doth magnify the Lord. And my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior.
Mary also needed a Savior. There is no immaculate concept. Like her, she was also born with a natural sin. Jesus died for her sin also. And Jesus has become her Savior also. Not only her son, Jesus was his Savior. I don't have time to get into the detail. We go to verse 48.
For he hath regarded the low estate of this handmaiden.
Number one, have faith. God has regarded the low esteem of her handmaiden. The Lord has considered. The Lord has thought this a matter. The low esteem of the Lord is regarded the low estate of his handmaiden. She's not a goddess. She self declares she's only a handmaiden, a slave. Now we understand this Mary is coming from a very poor family. And she is espoused to a carpenter. He is also a very poor man. Just imagine in your nearby vicinity a very poor girl. A very poor girl. In very low estate, not educated, not good clothes, not good anointing, not good proper oil for her hair. A very poor girl. A spouse to a coolie. Because today we think carpenter as a corporate business. Think about a coolie. He is also not rich. This man was that poor that for sacrifice also he could not buy a lamb. Such a poor fellow. Now Mary believes God regards, God considers even the low estate of his handmaid. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, I tell you, the first faith we should exercise, whatever our situations may be, however we are forsaken, left deprived, lonely, maybe because of age. Your children are not with you. You are left alone. Nobody to take care of you. Nobody thinks about you, nobody considers you. You are in a low estate. Maybe because of your family background. Father, mother, a strange relationship. Father has forsaken the family. Mother has forsaken the family. In the society, you are looked down by others. They call you. Appa per theriyada payanda. Like Japheth, you are going through a lot of sadness. Financially you may be low, socially you may be low, circumstantially you may be low, because the Lord has shut the womb of Hannah. Her life was bitter to her. Her soul was bitter to her. Maybe because you are denied of certain blessing, others are mocking at you, others are provoking you because of your past life. You got a self-condemnation. This morning, it is the word of God to you. The Lord is concerned of you. Hallelujah. Your daughters-in-law, your sons might have forsaken you. Your husband, your mother-in-law, the people of husband's family, they misunderstand you, mistreat you. This morning the Lord says, He regards the low estate of His handmaid. Hallelujah. Believe it. Not with a great excitement you should believe it. Like Mary, in a composed way, believe it. Whatever your background may be, however your spirit is low in this month, I bring the faith of Mary. God regards the low estate of His handmaid. God regards the low estate of His handmaid. At one point of time, God was able to exalt Job. God was able to exalt Hannah. God was able to exalt Joseph. God was able to exalt David. God will do the same thing to you. Blessed is he that believes. Blessed is he that believes. Others may not understand you. Others may not understand. Sister, we have come to the spirit of the saints. Just imagine, on that day, Mary was standing before Elizabeth and telling these words. Probably later to Luke, she narrated these words. Just imagine this morning, the Lord, Mary is standing just by your side, and Mary is telling you, I believe in Jesus. I believe in what the Lord told me. The Lord has got a regard for the lowest state of His handmaiden. எல்லாராலும் புறக்கணிக்கப்பட்ட அப்பா சரி கிடையாது, அம்மா சரி கிடையாது, மாற்றாம் தாய் சரி கிடையாது, எல்லாராலும் ஒதுக்கப்பட்டேன், எல்லாரும் என்னை கொத்தி கொதறி எடுத்தாரு. The Lord is speaking to somebody. I am fighting out my own life. In the name of Jesus, I tell you, the Lord has got a regard for the lowest state of His handmaid. My dear brother, my dear sister. Number 2, in the same verse, we read verse 48.
For behold, from henceforth all generations shall call me blessed.
Again, I love to draw that little word in English, for. Why I believe Him? Why my spirit rejoices in the Lord? Why my spirit rejoices in the Lord? My spirit rejoices in the Lord because I believed. I believed what? My Lord God has got regard for the low estate of His handmaiden. Number 2, why I rejoice? In English, that little word for is very important. For, look, she is telling Elizabeth, as she is telling Luke, and this morning she is telling you. She is telling you. Don't say that you are an orphan. Don't say you are forsaken. Don't say you are plucked out from your father and mother. The life is desolate. They call you by different names. They call you as a bad woman. Bad man. So many different things they call on you. Even your own people are unable to understand you. See the strength of her faith. She's a very poor woman. She's going to carry a bad name. She was with Elizabeth for 3 months. She was going back to Nazareth. 4th month, 5th month. It will be seen that she is with a child, without marriage. Without being married. What will the society talk about? Apart from biblical faith, can anyone imagine how Mary got conceived? There was a kuch talk about her. That is why it reached the ears of Joseph. Dear Mary, engaged to you. She is pregnant. She is pregnant. Even before marriage, she became pregnant. Joseph wanted to put her away. Her marriage became questionable. People are talking bad about you. For something really bad in you, or people talking bad about you without understanding it. All along in school, in college, you had a good name. Something happened in your life. You had an unacceptable relationship with a boy or a girl. Your mother started thinking you are bad. Your father started thinking you are bad. People can misunderstand you, or people can rightly understand you. David is a murderer, adulterer, womanger. So many things we can say against David. But many people call their children David. I mean, the Son of God is not ashamed to be called the Son of David. In this morning, you are in a very low estate. The whole world is going to speak against you. But have faith, for look, from henceforth, all generations shall call me blessed. I cannot imagine what type of faith that is. All people are going to call you. The woman with a child without a wedlock, her faith was different. From henceforth, let come what may, I don't know what others will talk about me, the Lord will change it. All generations will call me blessed. I can preach on it. I cannot understand the tremendous faith of Mary. If anybody here with a low estate, a low spirit, carrying a bad name with you, in the name of Jesus I tell you, when the Lord deals with you, when the Lord will perform in your life what He has spoken, He will make your name great. All generations will call you enviably happy. Enviably happy. Glory be to the Lord's holy name. The Spirit of the Lord is speaking to you, my dear brother, my dear sister. Number 3, we read in the next verse.
For He that is mighty hath done to me great things.
Again, I draw your attention a little way far. For He that is mighty hath done to me great things. What that He has done to her? What that He has done to her? Has He changed her financial situation? Has He taken away her ignominy, her shame? What that He has done? Her tremendous faith. The Lord has done to me great things. You are allowed to draw attention to the message, Hail Mary. Hail Mary. What is that the Lord has done to Mary? The government was giving a degree for the census when she was full of her pregnancy. Walking all the way from Nazareth to Jerusalem, climbing 300 feet to what that place was born, Bethlehem. What that God has done to me. When Jesus was born, there was not even a place for Jesus to be born. She gave birth to Jesus in Sidewaram, Roadwaram. You know what the Catholic Bible says? Under the tree, not in the manger. Manger, she laid the child. What that Lord has done for her? When Jesus was about 2 years old, King Herod wanted to kill the child. With Joseph, with the child, she was to run to Egypt. What the Lord has done to her? When the child was about 30 years, the eldest son, one who has to look after the mother, he left the family and went as a village preacher. What has the eldest son done to her? Even at the wedding of Cana, just went with him with one request, because she knew his supernatural birth. Here's a woman, what's between you and I? My time is not come, you leave it. We don't see her request was positively answered. What the Lord has done to her, ma? Brother, She says, the Lord has done to me great things. What that the Lord has done to me? All her other children are calling the elder son mad, demon possessed. She was explaining probably the miracle way the eldest child was born. Probably her own children could not believe it. Amma, they might have misunderstood the mother also. They are calling the eldest child mad. Annana paithiyam, pisasu pidichavan, chandra rogi pidichirukku. Emma, avana veetla kootu vandu katti poduvom. The children are telling her how much it would be painful. A grown up children are calling the elder son, avan paithiyam, ooru ura suthiyittu irukkan, avana pidichi veetla kondu katti poduvom. A sword went pierced through her heart that Jesus died on the cross. Naked. As she has seen the child in the manger, at least at that time, she was able to cover the child with the swaddling clothes. You know what is that swaddling clothes? With due respect, I tell you. In these days, women use sanitary wear. In those days, they use old clothes. Some women use those clothes and they might have thrown it away as a cloth of defilement. One commentator has explained this. I could not bear it. It should not be true. In the Jewish language, it exactly speaks about that cloth. Mary might have picked up that rag from somewhere. She washed that clothes and she covered his nakedness with a cloth of some women thrown away. But on the cross of Calvary, that Mary could not cover the nakedness of her own son. The son 33 years old, hanging on the cross, fully naked. A mother cannot bear it. But now she believed. We read that verse again.
For he that is mighty hath done to me great things, and
For
holy is his
name.
For
he that is mighty hath done to me great things. That she could understand only after the resurrection, when this Jesus came alive. My dear brother, my dear sister, faith is not what you see. Faith is what you believe. My God can do great things for me. I don't need faith to believe what I see. I need faith to believe what I don't see. Mary had a tremendous faith. My God has done to me great things. Believe that. We are in a very low estate. Things are seem to be negative. But today, 100%, I don't worship Mary. I don't even venerate Mary. I don't want to give any importance to Mary more than what the Bible gives. 100% I love Mary. I could not understand what the great thing the Lord has done in her life. Today, the world says, blessed is the womb that carried Jesus. Blessed are the paps which gave milk to Jesus. A blessed woman. Blessed is the womb that carried Jesus. Blessed are the paps that Jesus sucked. Today we know how blessed she is. No use in worshipping Mary. No use in saying, we all don't think about Mary. Both are unbiblical extremes. My dear brother, my dear sister, the faith of Mary is tremendous. She was not filled with the Holy Ghost or excited or with a loud voice. In a very composed way, she tells Elizabeth, I rejoice in my spirit. I rejoice in the Lord. I rejoice in my spirit, in my Savior. My Savior. Because He has done great things in my life. Hallelujah. Shall I lift up my hands and praise God? God will do great things in your life. Number four. Same verse we read.
For behold, from henceforth all generations call me blessed. For he that is mighty had done to me great things, and holy is his name.
Number four. Though we don't see the little word for, that little word and, because the Lord is mighty and He will do great things in my life, I rejoice in the Lord. Because His name is holy. The others are going to speak despicable things about Mary even today. Even today. One atheist was saying, உங்க அம்மாவாது, உங்க அக்காவாது, மனைவியாவது, கடவுளால் எனக்கு ஒரு குள்ள பிறந்துச்சு அப்படின்னா நீ ஒத்துக்குவியா? ஈவன் டுடே ஏத்திஸ்ட், தோஸ் ஹூ கான்ட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் திஸ் மிஸ்ட்ரி, தே ஸ்பீக் பேட் அபவுட் த பர்த் ஆஃப் ஜீசஸ் கிரைஸ்ட். வில் யூ அக்செப்ட் யுவர் சிஸ்டர் ஆர் யுவர் mother or your wife, anyone says that they got a child through God, will you accept? My dear brother, my dear sister. But she believed the name of the Lord is holy. I rejoice in the Lord because I am holy. He is holy. He is different from all the other gods. My dear brother, my dear sister, worship this Jesus. He is a holy God. He is different from all the other gods. The world cannot understand that. Only through faith you can understand. In your lowest state, be glad in the Lord. Let your soul magnify the Lord your God. Let your spirit rejoice in your Savior. Mary needed a Savior. Don't attach an immaculate concept to Mary and keep yourself away from Mary and be denied of the lessons you could learn from Mary. Mary is a woman with a passions like you and I. She needed a Savior. Certainly she was with her original sins. She is not a god, she is not a goddess, she is a handmaiden. Even once we meditated on the handmaid of Naaman. Now we are meditating on the handmaid of Lord. And number five, let's just say this and conclude. We read the next verse, 50.
and his mercy is on them that fear him.
I rejoice in the Lord. My spirit rejoices in my Savior, because his mercy is on them that fear him from generation to generation. I rejoice. Here only, amazing revelations he has got about the mercies of God. I don't have time to explain all these points. The fifth point itself is a sermon. What are the mercies of the Lord to them that fear him? Those who do preaching, Sunday school teaching, preaching in a prayer group, Bible study group, we can make note of these points. What are the mercies of God to them that fear him? We read from verse 51, read.
He had showed strength with his arm. He had scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts.
These are the mercies of God. Now, somebody who is very mighty, very proud, he imagines something against you in his heart. You are a person of a low estate. I don't have time to explain all the points. What are the mercies of God to them that fear him? What are the mercies of God that fear him? Or to them that fear him? Even some proud people imagine something against you in their heart. God will scatter that. There are many examples, but this one thing is predominant in my mind. There was a believer working in a central government office in a key post. His officer was against him mainly because of his Christian faith. He wanted to give him a punishment transfer to Delhi. The believer didn't say anything. The officer has got the authority. He has got the authority, the power. So he can transfer the believer. So he wanted to do it. He wanted to transfer him to Delhi. So he called his secretary and dictated the letter. In the evening, he was to attend a meeting in the afternoon. The secretary said the letter was ready. He said, keep it on my table, I will come and sign. He attended the meeting, went home. This officer, a very man of authority, received an urgent call from Delhi, a very powerful officer. His service is very much required in Delhi because of some problem, not as a punishment. His service is required in Delhi in a very urgent matter. So immediately come to Delhi. From this evening on forth, you are relieved from the office here. So you can't sign any letter or any check. He had an evil imagination. He wanted to transfer this believer. The letter was ready. He was to sign that letter in the next morning. The name of Jesus, I tell you, the Lord would scatter. The Lord would scatter the imagination of the proud people, those who are against you. They imagine so many things. The Lord is very powerful. A simple pastor, he was to start a congregation in the area the Lord has given him. that place was given to that pastor, a very ordinary pastor, by another Christian organization. In the same locality, there was a very big church. They didn't want this pastor, small pastor. They are like a mountain, he is like a mole. So they didn't want this pastor, that small kuti pastor, to come there. They approached that Christian organization. They persuaded them not to give this place to that pastor. So that Christian organization also, they met together, discussed, and they wanted to meet their senior pastor on Sunday, and they wanted to make sure they don't give this place to this kuti pastor. They all planned. That Sunday, Saturday evening, something happened. Some meeting, wall posters are put all over Tamil Nadu, just for a meeting in Pattabhiram. They put wall posters all over Tamil Nadu. That was to submission against that Christian organization which was giving the place to that kuti pastor. Sunday, that Christian organization saw these posters. They got very much infuriated against that mountain-like church. The Lord scattered the imagination of people. The Lord regards the lowest state of His handmaid, His servants. The mercies of God will show His arm strong towards you. He will scatter the imaginations of other people against you. It will scatter. My dear brother, my dear sister, with all humility I tell you. And what was the mercies could do? We read,
He had put down the mighty from their seats and exalted them of low degree.
He will, His mercies will exalt you. Verse 53.
He hath filled the hungry with the good things, and the rich He hath sent empty away.
He will satisfy your hungry soul with His goodness. 54.
He hath holpen His servant Israel in remembrance of His mercy.
Here He finishes with the mercy. He helps His servant Israel. His mercy is upon you. The name of Jesus I tell you. Number one, He regards the lowest state of His handmaid. He will make your name great. All generations will say that you are blessed. All generations will say that you are blessed. My dear brother, my dear sister, He will do great things for you. He will do great things for you. My dear brother, my dear sister, His name is holy, and His mercy is on them that fear Him from generation to generation. The Spirit of the Lord has spoken to you. Blessed is she that believed. We are going to participate in the Lord's Supper. You will truly be a blessed person if you could believe these things. Believe the Lord will exalt you from your lowest state. believe the Lord will change your name and all generations shall call you blessed. Believe the Lord will do great things in your life. Believe His name is holy. Believe always His mercies are upon them that fear Him. Shall we pray? Blessed is the person that believe. Hallelujah. Lord remembers you in your lowest state. Lord, you remembered Hannah, Job, Noah. In their lowest state, He remembers you. He regards you. He has got regard for you. He will not forget you. What He has told you, He'll make that come to pass.